I'm going to show you the easiest way to save the custom prompts that you find and actually use them directly without having to toggle between applications. This is really, really nice because if you do things that maybe format text, do insights, anything that you use regularly over and over again, it's going to save you a lot of time to just have it saved and be able to use it right off the bat. So if I pull up my AI assistant here, you can see all of these are my custom prompts that I've saved here. So let me find a fun one to pull up here. So a project proposal. So I don't actually do this anymore. I'm just going to put in some filler text there so I can show you the prompt. I used to run an outbound email agency. I stopped because it's really annoying. I'm going to stop this. And I used to do all of my project proposals for that agency. So basically what I did is I created a custom prompt that instructed it, gave it the formatting. And as you can see, this is a massive prompt. So I would definitely not want to write this out every time. And it's even kind of annoying to just have to copy and paste it into ChatGPT or something. So now I can just take the voice note or, you know, any notes I have, run this prompt on it, and it will write my project proposal for me. Let me do another one here just so you kind of get an idea. This is one I did yesterday. I'm really amped on this one. So this one is a insert research prompt. So basically, if I'm writing a blog post or I guess it could be anything. It could be like a social media post, could be whatever. It will find points to add in evidence, and it will go find a research article or something online and give me a citation to include. And this isn't a super long prompt, but it would be really annoying to just have to ask it every time. And again, I just have to toggle back and forth. So I should say, if you're curious in any of these prompt, I do actually save mine so I can share them with everyone in this spreadsheet. I'll put a link to it in this video. So again, there's the research one. Taking video and podcast notes. Oh gosh, that's a really good one. There's so many good custom AI prompts in here. You should definitely check it out. But let's kind of cover how to actually save it. So naturally, these are going to exist already, but let me pretend I'm going to do my format exercise one. So I can just kind of take this and I will copy the prompt there. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to pull up any AI prompt. It oftentimes is useful to choose a similar one. So I'm going to pretend I don't already have this prompt in here. Let me say a formatting one. So maybe like my stream of consciousness is kind of a formatting one. So I'll just put some filler text in there since I'm not running it on anything. And I'll pull up this prompt here. And because I've now, let me stop that text going. Because I've now already copied it, I could actually just take all of this and paste in my new prompt. And there we go. I don't actually want to do this because I'm not going to overwrite my prompt. So normally, probably what you'd want to do is actually clone it, and that it just copies it and you can give it a new name. So I would say format exercises, and now I can save it. And again, I'm not going to because I already have this one, but I could save that, and then I can go into the gym and take my voice notes and it will format all of my exercises for me. And you can do that process with anyone. I should note to maybe give like an actual example. So let me say today I need to go to the grocery store. And then if I were actually running a prompt on this, I would just do Command J to pull up the assistant. And maybe I want it to list the action items as tasks. There's only one here. So let's see how it does on that one. And it will run it on whatever text is highlighted there. So before, when you saw me putting in filler text, that's just because it needs something to run on. Otherwise, it has no context. So I'll put that in there. I'll replace it. And there it has it as a task that I can check off. So I think this is by far the easiest way to save these AI prompts because you can run them on text directly from within your notes. It's like being able to save and run custom AI prompts directly within that notes. So super, super powerful. Go give it a try. I will include a link to reflect this application here, and also my AI note-taking prompts and templates. I didn't mention the templates, but I have a separate tab for templates here that aren't AI related. It's a little less exciting.